he definitely can upset players who are, you know, ranked very highly. It's just that, you know, with the matchup, with how good Zane is against Fox in general, this is going to be potentially really, really tough. Look at that. He's got one of those elbow pillows.
I was about to say,
like,
we have a pillow ditto.
We got a pillow ditto.
We got the first.
And they both start with Z-A in their names. They got four-letter tags. There's a lot of similarities here when you get down to brass tacks.
It's honestly, it feels like a little bit of a team kill.
A little bit, in a weird way. Yeah, in a weird way. So I'm wearing what I have to assume is the melee stats tag. It's kind of cool. We do have Wheat running things.
That's right. Yep. Yeah, shout outs.
Shout outs to
Ambien and Edwin as well.
Are they here?
No.
Okay.
But shout outs. So,
yeah, you know, just
in absentia. Yep.
Yeah. Isn't there, aren't there more? Isn't there like Chroma C still?
I think they're in they're adjacent. The melee stats adjacent. But
The double dash tag.
Oh, wow. Keeping the combo going.
Yeah. Zane making a reference to the Mario Kart game.
Double dash attack.
Yes.
Yeah, if you looked at the player cam, he looked at us and winked.
And winked.
Yeah.
Yeah, you knew that was for Mario Kart fans all over the world. Right. Zabu keeping it close right here.
Yeah. I like this. Ooh. Also, the down tilts are hard to break into, and as soon as Zambu starts to break into center stage, that's a hard match. Did you see that?
She got an up-B for, you know, if you shined, it actually would have broken out of the chain grab, but, you know, at that point, you're just mashing. Wow, he probably accidentally down threw and reacted. Can't imagine he did that on purpose.
You think so? Actually, no, yeah, you're right.
Maybe down on purpose. I love that shine, yeah. Zane tried to get above him to go for the downer. Whoa! I gotta tell you, some little itty-bitty flubs coming out from Zane with some of these aerials that he's probably not trying to do.
Yeah.
That was a strange choice.
And it's gotta be a little bit of an acclimation back to this environment, because I don't remember the last in-person tournament that Zane had competed in. Was it Smash Summit 11?
Yeah, it had to have been Summit.
Yeah.
It had to have been Summit.
Yeah. Oh my gosh, a really soft nair. It looked like it was almost a tech trap on that platform. And then he was able to get the up smash off of the no tech.
Yeah. So he probably touched okay, not using a double jump there. All right. Zamu, had a little tiny lead. Carefully. Okay. Love that he didn't tech in place there, making it as hard as possible for Zane to follow up. That was really nice. Talking about how hard it is to break in on that that down tilt, but he actually straight up just whip punished one there.
Yeah, that's right. So tough. Especially like, a high startup move with lag like up smash too. I mean, that's courage.
It is, yeah. Oh, he had an opportunity. And he thought Zane was going to tech on the top platform. Oh, I like the crouch.
He's definitely looking for it. I'm looking maybe for a... He dash dances around the short hop bear.
That's so hard to do. You know, it's very rare to me that a top player... Because, like, Zamu was really telegraphing that he was looking for an up smash. He whipped, like, three.
Yep.
And I usually really don't like when a Fox keeps going for the same option over and over because a top player will sniff it out. But it actually worked.
Yeah, absolutely. I think that's like an incredibly hard dash dance to do because he's spacing really, really close to Marth.
Yeah.
Which is like, that's an ambiguous spacing for especially Zane, like a Marth that will change his threatening hitboxes just by a little bit.
Yeah, definitely. It's very hard. I mean, anyone who's ever tried to fight like a good Marth player knows it's usually almost, it's nigh impossible to truly whiff punish the forwarder. You usually try to punish what they do after the forwarder. You call out their dash back if they up tilt or down tilt.
Right.
Well, Zane here answering back with some nice slide-offs from Zamu, but Zane's keeping the combo going. Ouch, pivot tipper.
Gets the pivot tipper here. Now, this is a pretty crucial moment for Zamu, but Zane snuffs out the candle. Wow.
Man, Zamu keeping that game so close all game, but Zane just had that extra little bit of secret sauce.
That's right.
At the
it
end
felt
of that
like
game
it,
one.
It really came down to the micro moments, right? Because like some of the openings that Zamu got in that last game, it felt like, wow, these are really execution based. They're a lot based off of the spacing rather than just like out macroing him or beating him via game plan.
Yeah.
And so what I'm really looking for is just like if the players can execute in these really close scraps, being the indicator for who's going to be winning. Nice tech from Zamu.
Yeah, that crouch tech, or not crouch, you're not truly crouching, but holding down and teching. They went for that one. Worth going for.
Oh, he actually lands on the platform. I was surprised.
Yeah, that's like a little setup from him, I think. Up throw.
Oh, single hit nair.
If he like L canceled that and did something off it, that would have been really impressive. Every time you see Zane going for that forwarder, by the way, on that offstage up B, he's usually trying to get the weak hit. And you saw he got that at the end of the last game. You want that weak hit because they can't really DI it to go up. They always will just kind of go outward.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I think maybe even at that high percent, especially on Yoshi's, it might just like kill outright if it's Tipper as well.
Oh.
Nice from Zambu, actually threatening that airspace, which I think can be a little bit threatening against Marth, getting hit by an aerial, but...
Oh, wow.
Wow, yeah, that DI on the up tilt.
And the DI, I mean, it wasn't even the worst DI, but in conjunction with the small size of the stage,
yeah.
It's very tough.
Dying at 63, that is, that's not, doesn't feel good.
Oh, wow.
Little bit of pushes right now. And Zambu actually interrupts Zane's forward smash with his drill there, but can't really get much more off of it.
Oh, love the empty
land there. Hop. Oh, and he does it again onto the platform. Is this going to be another...
Oh, he's shot it.
No, he's nuts. He's nuts. Did you see the shy guy almost assisting, like, delaying the back air a little bit?
Yeah. Extending the hitbox or what have you. Nice read there.
Yeah.
Not even wanting to sit up for the down tilt, just grabbing the ledge.
That's right. Zambu having a few flubs right now, which I think is really going to be
a game ender. Oh, he's got no jump. Yeah. Oh, you're gone. Yeah. No Randall in sight. The cloud is long tucked away. Nowhere to be found. And wow, Zane's starting to wake up a little bit.
That's right. Yeah. I definitely do feel like the momentum, especially for like the favorite player going into the set. We see sometimes like it'll be a close game one that they clinch, but as they start to sort of get back into form, they switch back very, very quickly.
Yeah, it's starting to feel like that kind of set. Starting to feel like a story we've seen before. Ooh, man, and he keeps it going with the tech chases, the platform tech chases. Of course, Marth with that, he can double jump NIL, no impact land onto those side platforms. Really strong option.
Ouch. Yeah, absolutely. It does feel like pretty hopeless as a fast faller getting onto platform versus Zane.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Zane's so good at fighting through that crouch cancel. Even knowing that that's the Junebug classic, going for that crouch cancel dash up on the down tilt, but Zane is minding his spacing. Ooh!
Oh! Tries to go for another down air there, but doesn't quite get it. I think a few positioning... They got stuck in their crouches there.
Yeah.
Oh, a little bit of a fake out. That's a redacted dash.
Oh, the weird little scramble there.
Yeah,
Zane had the CC.
Zane was going for a crouch cancel grab, but gets a shield out instead.
Yeah. That's right. Oh, he's trying to break his ankles. He's trying to break his ankles. Hang on a minute.
I do think Zane maybe was feeling frustrated, like getting stuck. Ooh, Phantom.
Yeah, now he's trying to prove a point.
Yeah. I can move.
I also think that like when you have a lead and I feel like for Zane, somebody like Zane, getting a little bit custom is gonna loosen him up a little and it's gonna make him kind of, it's actually gonna make him hit his fundamentals more cleanly as well.
Yeah,
kind of goes
yeah.
both ways.
Sort of a more abstract, like getting back in the groove.
Yeah. Because you can see that the more he goes for, like the way he started really pulling ahead that Yoshi's game was just getting a little crazy.
That's
oh my
right.
God,
Saucy. Mythicat. Okay. And as Zambu in this position, you're definitely trying to, at least for me, I'm a bit of a cooler, right? Try to like just get them off this momentum.
Oh, he's doing some crazy stuff. I think he probably could have just doubted, but you know what? I like it. I like it. Oh my
he's
God.
Dead. Come on. Come
oh
on.
My God, he's dead.
All right. Yeah, this is really tough for Zambu. I think.
He's just dancing around him now.
It is a little bit rude. I'd like Zane to be a gentleman and gimp him.
Oh, he's pivot jabbing him for no reason at all. He's literally just having fun.
I think this is an investment for future sets.
Yeah.
You know
yeah.
I mean? Yeah. This is for Aklo, for him to be like, did you see what I did to Zane?
That's right. Jeez, he's falling up any which way. Zambu getting sort of tricky with these slide outs. It literally doesn't even matter. Literally none of it matters because Zane is following everything up.
That's right. It does feel like Wild Dreamland gives Zamu a little bit more time, more interactions to like get information.
Yeah.
It doesn't really matter when Zane has conversions that are so consistent that always keep Zamu in a punish. Where like you're not dying at 60, you're just dying at 120, but still off of just one neutral.
Yeah, I mean, I think a big part of it for Zane that particular game was those no impact lands on the side platforms, where a lot of Marths, you know, you'll tech on the side platform, and then they kind of have a tough time, you know, covering all the options with up air or up tilt or what have you because of the, you know, the nature of the side platforms are a little bit higher than on some other stages.
Yeah.
Not Battlefield, notably. But Zane consistently, every time he wasn't sure if, like, you know, up air was, or if he was sure that up air wasn't the right option, he would just wave land onto the platform or no impact land on the That's platform right. and continue the tech chase with more grabs. And I think when they play like that and they're able to take their tech chases and their